What's up, and welcome to another episode of Gizmo Slip Tech. If you're a fan of gaming and technology, please consider subscribing. We're going to talk about the gaming laptops of the year for 2021. I have five of my top gaming laptops, and yes, I will select the winner. And actually, at this point, it's a toss-up between two of them, but I'm going to have to select by the time I'm done filming this video. It's tough to decide. Now, before we continue, I gotta give a big shout out and thank you to Best Buy for sponsoring this episode. They've asked me to go over some of the current deals on their website. Now, as per the sponsorship contract, I can be open and honest about what I think about the deals on their website. So let's go ahead and take a look at what they have on sale.
All right, so here is Best Buy's site. They constantly are changing and updating the deals available on here every few days. So there's a link down below. Let's go ahead and take a look at their top most popular deals. Lenovo IdeaPad Gaming 3i. This is an excellent casual gaming laptop, only 8 gigs of RAM. You'll probably want to upgrade that later on, but for $599, this is going to be tough to beat in the casual gaming segment. We have the Acer Nitro 5. For $699, you get a 144Hz display. Again, only 8 gigs of RAM and even a smaller SSD on this one. So there's some trade-offs here. Overall, this is a decent deal for a casual gamer, but don't expect an amazingly bright and vibrant display, but at least it's 144Hz. Next, we have the GF65 with an RTX 3060 and an $899 price point. That is tremendous value, but this is a lower TDP RTX 3060. And again, the display is not that bright and vibrant, though it is 144Hz. And you only have 8 gigs of RAM. If you have a tight budget of $900, this is a decent deal, but ideally I would recommend saving a bit more. The Lenovo Legion 7 Slim. This has a high performance processor, 16 gigs of memory, RTX 3060 Max Q, 512 gig SSD. This thing's normally been priced about $1,500. This is definitely one of the better deals right now on Best Buy's site. Next up, we have the ROG Flow X13. This thing is an amazing ultrabook if you're looking for something super thin and light and portable. RTX 3050 Ti, 8-core processor, 16 gigs of RAM for $1,249 if you need something super thin, light, and portable. Otherwise, get a thicker machine that can provide more performance. Next up, we have the Zephyrus G14. Fantastic, fully featured 14-inch gaming laptop, super portable and very powerful for its size. At $1,399, this is a decent deal, but I have seen this go as low as $1,249. So if you're patient, you can probably see it come all the way back down to that price again someday. Next up, we have the Zephyrus G15 with an RTX 3070 QHD display, high-end processor, really fantastic laptop. This is an absolutely superb laptop for the price of $1,549. Two giant thumbs up on this one right here. Then we have the Zephyrus M16 with an RTX 3060 for $1,649. This is just not a good enough deal right now, especially not when the G15 costs less and is more powerful.
So again, big shout out and thank you to Best Buy for sponsoring this episode. So before we get talking about the specific gaming laptops, I just want to give my brief overview thoughts on gaming laptops for the year, the progress we've made so far. So 2021 has been quite an exciting year because gaming laptops have gone from, like, oftentimes you're gonna have to turn the settings down and kind of struggle to hit certain frame rates, but now in 2021 the top gaming laptops can easily do ultra settings at QHD resolution, especially overkill at 1080p, and even many of these gaming laptops can do the high and ultra settings even at 4K depending on what kind of frame rate and which game you're playing. In addition, we saw more and more laptops with MUX switches allowing for better and better performance, especially in esports and FPS heavy games. We've seen Advanced Optimus included in more laptops this year than ever before, which is exciting, but it has been a buggy implementation. So in 2022, I really hope they can iron out some of those wrinkles. In addition, I really want to see Windows have better power management so that we can prevent our battery life from draining away from just random applications, just killing our battery life. Build quality across all the laptops, the entire space has dramatically improved. I feel like keyboards, trackpads are just getting better and better. I don't think I tried a single laptop this year that had just like an utterly crappy trackpad. They were all at least decent and functional, with some being truly excellent. In addition, gaming laptop companies are getting better and better at cooling their laptop, being able to put higher power limit GPUs and CPUs in thinner laptops. And to top it off, the laptops are getting thinner with smaller bezels around the display, allowing these gaming laptops with really high levels of performance to be ultra portable, which I love that. You look at even a mid-level $1,200, $1,500 gaming laptop from today and you compare it to gaming laptops from 2 years ago that cost $3,000 or $4,000, and a $1,200, $1,500 gaming laptop today can outperform those really expensive laptops, and they do it in super thin and light chassis that weigh maybe even half as much. Now for 2022, the areas that I think gaming laptops could really improve would be the battery life segment, like I mentioned before, better battery life management. I really want on-the-fly GPU switching that provides true direct connection between the GPU and the display, so we have maximum performance all the time with maximum battery life all the time. In addition, I want zero latency wireless gaming mice and headphones. There's no reason we need cables in 2022, so let's ditch those cables and let's have true zero latency without a dongle that are just easier to take with us on the go. And lastly, I want all laptops in 2022 to have a webcam, and I want them to have better quality cameras. There's no reason why we have to have pixelated, low quality cameras on our gaming laptops that we're paying $2,000, sometimes $3,000 or $4,000 for.
This is the fans on maximum now, so you'll probably not want to have fans on maximum when you're using the webcam.
So those are the areas I think gaming laptops can really improve in 2022, some low-hanging fruit that I hope some manufacturers take a look at and offer up some good solutions for. I also want to mention some specific laptops that are excellent that I did not get a chance to test or that didn't quite make the cut. The Asus Zephyrus S17 has basically been sold out or unavailable for purchase much of the year. Same for the Zephyrus Duo 15. I really, really like these two laptops, but they just really weren't available for me to even purchase. They're basically not contenders for this list because I didn't have a chance to review them. And then we have the Asus G15 Advantage Edition. Well, I think this is an excellent laptop. I just didn't quite feel that it had what it took to quite make it on this list. If this was a top 10 gaming laptop list, then it would definitely be on here. But it's like 6th or 7th, I think, so not quite on the top 5. All right, so first up on the list is the Alienware X17. This is a very innovative and interesting build from Alienware. Now, for each of the primary laptops on this list, I'm also going to have a couple of honorable mentions that are very similar or perhaps was replaced by the primary laptop later on in the year. So the honorable mentions for the X17 is the Alienware M15R4 and M17R4, both of which were high-powered gaming laptops from Alienware that were their top dog options earlier in 2021. But getting back to the X17, I really like the Alienware X17 because it had such high GPU power limits, up to 165 watts in a super thin profile. In addition, we had excellent 4K 120Hz, 100% Adobe RGB display options, and to top it off, we had some of the fanciest RGB designs with a light-up touchpad and beautiful Tron light on the back. But there was a number of downsides to the X17. You know, it's a very heavy laptop for how thin it is. It's also one of the most expensive laptops of the year. And quite frankly, I didn't love the port selection or the feel of the keyboard. So it didn't quite rank at the very, very tippy top of the list for those reasons. But I do think that the X17 is worthy of being in the top 5 spot, just maybe not in the top 3. Next up, we have the MSI GP66, with honorable mentions going to the MSI GP76, the 17-inch version of the 7 laptop, and the GE66 and GE76, which are the more premium versions of this lineup. Overall, the main reason why I selected the MSI GP66 is because of its superb performance for the dollar. And near the end of 2021, the top end spec of the RTX 3080 version has been going for $1,799, which is an absolutely fantastic deal. Now, another reason why I selected the GP66 is that the 125 watt GPU, whether that's an RTX 3070 or 3080, is higher than average for a 15 inch chassis. In addition, we have great chassis build quality, a lovely keyboard and trackpad. We've got a MUX on here, and and a high-quality 1080p 240Hz gaming display. The primary downsides to the GP66 is that the bottom panel is difficult to remove, so if you want to customize it and upgrade with RAM or SSDs, it's going to be a bit of a pain to take that bottom panel off. In addition, there is no USB-C port, so that's going to be a deal breaker for a lot of people. Next up, we have the Aorus 15G, and honorable mentions go to the Aorus 15P, though I wouldn't recommend the Aorus 17G unless you can find it on a big sale. So why did I love the Aorus 15G? Well, it has an excellent keyboard with a number pad in a lightweight portable package, and this is one of the few laptops that is this thin, this light, this powerful, that has the keyboard and numpad on it. So if you needed a numpad, this is one of the best options for that reason. In addition, I really like the feel of the keyboard and trackpad. This is one of the best all around in terms of quality of feel and the ports and keyboard overall package, especially given the very reasonable price. This was one of the easier laptops to find in stock in 2021, and I really felt like you got what you paid for on it. If there were any cons to this laptop, it's that the laptop was thinner and you had a lower power limit on that GPU, sacrificing some performance for portability. In addition, there was no QHD display option. So if you really wanted a QHD display, you couldn't go this route, or really the MSI GP66 for that matter. Okay, we're on to the last two, and I've decided which laptop's going to be game of the year. Okay. The Legion 7i is the game of the year if you wanted the ultimate performance in a gaming laptop and you're willing to pay a premium price for it. Now, the honorable mentions for the Legion 7i go out to the Legion 7, Legion 5, Legion 5 Pro. Those laptops offered additional options and price points and Ryzen CPUs if you're interested in paying less money or buying a Ryzen processor instead of Intel. Here's the Legion 7i. This is a laptop I've been using personally now for several months. And I gotta tell you, this laptop has an incredible keyboard, touchpad, chassis. We've got a webcam, a 16 by 10 aspect ratio QHD display that's very bright and vibrant, though the color gamut on the display is not as high of a color gamut as some of the other laptops out there. It's only about 100% sRGB instead of 100% Adobe RGB. This thing offers a thin overall package while still packing the highest level of power limits in any of the laptops I tested this year. But the laptop wasn't perfect. It suffered from mediocre battery life. In addition, Advanced Optimus I found would be pretty buggy overall. So I treated it more just like a straight up muck switch, where I just switched from dedicated graphics to battery life mode with a restart. Other cons is that the aluminum chassis can get very warm under extended loads. It's a very pricey, premium, expensive laptop, and there was usually a long delay if you actually wanted to buy one of these laptops. But overall, the Legion 7i to me wins laptop of the year if you have an unlimited budget. But if you didn't have an unlimited budget and instead were a mid-tier budget user like the vast majority of people, then my number one pick for gaming laptop of the year for 2021 was the Zephyrus G15. Now, the honorable mentions related to the Zephyrus G15 is the SCAR 15, the SCAR 17, the Strix G15, the Strix G17, and lastly, the Zephyrus G14. So the SCAR 15 and 17 were more the premium, a little bit thicker version of the Zephyrus. You've got the Strix G15, G17, which were kind of the thicker but less premium version, a little bit higher power limit. Then you have the Zephyrus G14, which was the thinner, more portable version of the Zephyrus G15. But the best overall package for the vast majority of people was the Zephyrus G15 because of its excellent high color gamut QHD display that provided great gaming quality as well as just general media consumption. When you combine that great display with the portability, the thinness, the great battery life, the solid keyboard and excellent touchpad, the great overall speakers, and just enough gaming performance to play the vast majority of AAA games at 60 to 150 FPS, depending on the game, obviously, and what settings you use, it just provides enough gaming performance in such a thin and portable and affordable package. It's just a real winner in my book for the vast majority of people out there. Now, the primary cons for this device is the lack of an authentic MUX switch, but still the implementation of on-the-fly GPU switching was seamless and well done, in many ways better than the advanced Optimus and MUX iterations that I saw in the other gaming laptops. Yes, the lack of an authentic MUX or advanced Optimus did cut into the gaming performance, but the additional convenience that you get from on-the-fly GPU switching that is reliable and effective, it's just so nice. And it really makes me look forward to when manufacturers figure out how to do on-the-fly advanced Optimus GPU switching, so we get this same implementation from the Zephyrus G15, but with true direct connection to the display. Another downside, we don't have a webcam, which is just so sad. Like, I really wish Asus threw a webcam on this thing, but I just felt like it really hit a sweet spot, especially when the Zephyrus G15 is on sale, like it is right now. It is just such an incredible bang for the buck and fantastic value for the majority of gamers out there. So in conclusion, it's been incredible to see how far we've come in gaming laptops for 2021. Like, for me, the only reason why I really still have a desktop is because I want to play high-end VR games on really high resolution, which was pushing like 2 4K displays at the same time. And gaming laptops aren't quite there if you want to do the highest end of VR. I mean, realistically, not even gaming desktops can play that level of VR flawlessly yet. I think gaming laptops are just gonna keep getting better and better, and I can't wait to see what the bright future holds for all of us gaming laptop enthusiasts out there. So what gaming laptop would you say deserves the Gaming Laptop of the Year award? Let me know in the comments down below. If you enjoyed this video, hit that like button. And if you wanna see more of my content, hit that subscribe button. I will see you in the next one. Brandon out.